We've talked about a few Kingsguard members over the years on the channel, and it's about time to make a dedicated video on the OGs. Before there was even a Red Keep or small council, the first Targaryen king had an established Kingsguard in a time where his head would bring in a pretty penny. The story of its formation is kind of what George Martin focused on, and not so much about the backstory and feats of each individual original member. Before an official Kingsguard was established, Aegon did have some men by his side guarding him, but his older sister and wife, Visenya Targaryen, believed they just weren't good enough when all of Dorne wanted the first ever king of the Seven Kingdoms dead. Aegon was never able to fully conquer Dorne, but kept up his assault on the region atop the family dragons. They kept this up for years, and it led to the Dornish putting a hit on Aegon along with his sister. Aegon already lost one sister to Dorne, and they were set on taking everything from him. The most powerful man in this world was being hunted by random assassins. Then, in 10 AC, 10 years after Aegon united the Seven Kingdoms, both Aegon and Visenya were attacked in the streets of King's Landing. It was actually Visenya that saved the day with her Valyrian steel sword called Dark Sister. She was just as notable of a warrior as her brother, and proved it this day. Aegon only made it out alive because of Visenya, even though Cool Guy Aegon had a larger and more desired Valyrian steel sword called Blackfire. This story is all about ass-whooping, blonde-braided Visenya from here on out. I don't want to hype her character up too much. She becomes a little twisted later in life after Aegon passed. She was a more cautious one. When their lives were most at risk, Visenya would wear chainmail all night and day, prepared for an ambush. But her vigilant eyes couldn't always be by his side. Aegon had a more easygoing approach, and was satisfied with his guards even after almost losing his life in his own capital. He wasn't interested in walking around and sleeping with some metal on. Visenya had to show him how wrong he was. The moment Aegon mentioned that his guards would suffice, Visenya took out her sword Dark Sister and cut his cheek before his guards could react. "Your guards are slow and lazy," she said. "I could have killed you as easily as I cut you. You require better protection." King Aegon, bleeding, had no choice but to agree. The newly informed Aegon allowed his older sister to handle the details, since she was obviously more qualified. The custom for the previous Westerosi kings was to have a champion defend them, a sworn shield, like a head of security. But this king ruled over seven kingdoms, not one. One sworn shield wouldn't suffice. Seven Kingsguard was the number Visenya came up with to match the realms. And I personally think Martin just liked to go with the theme of seven introduced with the Faith of the Seven, something very prominent in Westeros. Visenya sought out the finest knights in the realm. Not the strongest or most skilled, but men she believed would have unquestioning loyalty. Ones who would sacrifice their life for their king without hesitation. This is why Visenya would not give any consideration to Aegon's plan of holding a tourney for all the countless knights offering themselves as candidates. The Targaryens were still looked at as outsiders, and monstrous conquerors to some on this continent. A skilled fighter that close in their inner circle would be asking for trouble. It had only been a decade since many fields, castles, and families were scorched by the dragons. Visenya used her diligence, and soon enough found her seven knights. It would be a brotherhood fashioned in the likeness of the Brothers of the Night's Watch. Queen Visenya took inspiration from their challenging vows, a vow that would test their willingness to serve for life. Pretty extreme stuff. Like the Black Crows, her white swords would surrender all lands, titles, and worldly goods to live a life of chastity and obedience with no other reward aside from honor. They were given a white cloak and armor to signify their purity. It would be something every boy and knight dreamed of wearing, to be looked at as heroes. Visenya didn't discriminate against age or stature, because some were old and some short, coming from every corner of the realms. We're supposed to believe nobility status didn't have a factor, but I don't know. The Lord Commander just happened to hail from the Targaryen's closest allies. Definitely some favoritism going on here. But Visenya's top priority was devotion to the crown. The first ever Lord Commander, Corlys Velaryon, would lead the brothers. Why I say there was some favoritism with this selection in particular is because of the deep ties between House Targaryen and House Velaryon. So we all know that the Targaryens originated from the Valyrian Peninsula over to the eastern continent. But they weren't the only ones. It's believed House Velaryon migrated from Valyria to Westeros even before the Targaryens, but no one cares too much about them, because they weren't one of the Dragonlord families who had the ability to tame dragons running in their veins. They're more known for their sailing capabilities. They actually had a big impact in Aegon's conquest, as some of his first supporters captaining the naval fleet. Out of every house in the Targaryen's family tree, the Velaryons married into the Targaryen family the most. Aegon's mother was in fact a Valyrian, and so would many of his descendants. Master of ships would be the customary position appointed to Valyrians under the crown, but Corlys got the honor of being the first ever Lord Commander of the Kingsguard. It seems like he was the younger son born to their Lord Father, which does make the whole casting aside everything you own easier. It's not like he was going to inherit much of the family wealth and power anyways. Next on this prestigious list is Sir Robin Darklyn, hailing from another major house not too far away from where the Targaryens reside. He had the nickname of Dark Robin. During the time before the conquest, the Darklyns were actually petty kings of their own small kingdom where part of the Crownlands now exists. They were some of the first to be defeated and bend the knee to Aegon before feeling the full wrath of the dragons. This house is so proud of Dark Robin's rank that they immortalized his achievement along with some other members of the family on their sigil. House Darklyn has given the crown the most members of the Kingsguard out of any other family in the realm. The seven shields on their sigil representing the seven Darklyn members that have been appointed. But the family's entire legacy would go up in flames during the reign of the Mad King over 250 years later. The Darklyn's power dwindled as King's Landing grew more and more populous. Their port, which is close by, made the Darklyns obsolete. Out of desperation and stupidity, the Lord here, during the time of the Mad King, captured and held the king captive. After the Mad King was freed, he made sure to end the line of Darklyns forever. It's only a matter of time before their record of most Kingsguard members will be overtaken now, if this order will still be around after the events of the main story. Richard Root is one of the other original members, House Root being one of the smaller houses in the Riverlands. So this is where Visenya's claim of not discriminating begins. There was even a base-born son and a Hedge Knight amongst the first seven Kingsguard. Sir Addison Hill was called the Bastard of Cornfield. Not an actual cornfield, that's just the name of House Swift's seat in the Westerlands. So he was probably a bastard born of their line. Addison would actually rise to the position of Lord Commander of the Kingsguard sometime after Sir Corlys Velaryon. It is stated two of the original seven brothers did die defending their king. Which two isn't exactly given to us. It's safe to assume Corlys was one of them though. The Hedge Knight was Humphrey the Mummer, who judging by his name seems to be an interesting guy. A mummer is this world's way of calling someone an actor in a play or performance. And a hedge knight is a knight with no stable employer like a lord, so they tend to travel around with not much to their name looking for work, at times left with no choice but to sleep under a hedge. So Humphrey really had to prove his worth to Visenya. The last two members were brothers, literal brothers, Sir Griffith Good and Gregor Good. They had to have some powerful genes if both were selected to serve at the same time. I just think of the Hound and the Mountain when these guys are mentioned. House Good is one of the few houses with absolutely no information written about them. No sigil, no location, no liege lord, nothing. And there's no current members of this family in the present story, so it may remain that way. The assassination attempts on King Aegon's life ended in 13 AC when the Martells gave Aegon a letter that changed his course of action in conquering the final kingdom. He burned this mystery letter that clearly held something over his head, likely having to do with his younger sister Rhaenys, who is believed to have died fighting here. Aegon finally agreed to peace terms with Dorne, but some threats would always persist. All seven of these guys were quick, strong, observant, skilled with the sword and shield, and devoted to their king. Creating a Kingsguard was a good move, but that's all the info we get on the members, a blanket statement with all of them getting a thumbs up. You would think we'd get a little more about the original seven Kingsguard in Fire and Blood, but this lore book copy and pasted word for word the fake history about them from the World of Ice and Fire that came out years prior. But to be fair, this book is focused solely on the Targaryen family, not their glorified bodyguards, to my dismay. I've talked about Daenerys' Queensguard, but I've also been meaning to talk about the only other Queensguard in this story. Spoilers, it was another Targaryen brat. That'll be out one day. See ya.